This morning I take an excerpt from Taushabuddha Upanishad Volume 2, A Religion Without God, Religion of Meditation. An excerpt from Taushabuddha Upanishad Volume 2, A Religion Without God. Mind wanders. Can there be religion without God? Mind wanders. Can there be any religion without God? This is how the mind is. Mind goes on inquiring and asking questions that have no relevance. Indeed, going out of the mind is the beginning of the process of meditation. Going out of the mind can be in two ways. You can go below the mind and you can go beyond the mind. When you go below the mind, it is madness. And when you go beyond the mind, it is no mind. Apparently, the two looks the same. But there is a vast difference. When you go below the mind, you are unconscious. When you go beyond the mind, you are totally conscious and aware. Meditation is the only method that helps to remove all the barriers. It is like spade work. Weeds are removed, thoughts are removed, and finally mind is removed. It is just a removal. Indeed, it is a negative process that goes on rejecting everything that is inside, so that one day there is nothing to reject. All that can be thrown out has been thrown out already, and you have a pure inner space, and that space is the right preparation. In that space, the seed of intuition that you have been carrying all along suddenly bursts forth unpredictably. This happens always unpredictably. One cannot say what will happen, but one thing is certain, it does happen. That much can be said. However, the time cannot be predicted, but it happens. If the space is ready, it happens sooner or later. And it is always sooner rather than later. It is like slipping out of your mind, just as a snake slips out of its own old skin. It is not a science. Instead, it is an art, or to be more precise, it is a knack. So too, meditation is the nap. Meditation is the simplest art. It teaches you how to be silent. Meditation is non-doing. Then how can it be difficult? Yet people find it difficult to attain. This is the way of laziness to attain enlightenment. You do not do anything to attain. This inward silence or enlightenment. This inward silence or enlightenment is your intrinsic nature. You have it in the seed form. It only requires the right environment and process. When you look within, you realize you are the beauty. the silence, the ecstasy, and the blissfulness. You need to be kind to yourself. Just sit silently, do nothing, rather either physically or mentally. Do nothing, either physically or mentally. Just sit silently and remember grass grows by itself. You can do things, you can cook, you can fix the car. All this involves doing. But relaxation is a non-doing process. You will definitely find it difficult in the beginning because your whole gestalt is that of the outer world, the dimension of doing. By nature, you are addicted to doing, and therefore it will take time to vanish. Just be, relax and watch. This being is not doing. Sit silently doing nothing. Witness whatsoever happens. Thoughts will float in the mind. The body may feel tension. Be on the hill a watcher of all that is happening in the valley. This is knack. This is your nature. This is meditation. This is ultimate flowering. Meditation is not just science or art. It is either both or none. In fact, meditation is a knack. Old habits continue to play their part. Thoughts continue to rush. Thoughts continue in the rush hour. Your body is not accustomed to sitting silently. You can remain the whole night dancing and partying without a blink. But when you are asked to sit silently, you feel uncomfortable, you feel sleepy, you feel tired, you feel bored. The mind's wavelength reaches below 4 and you fall asleep, you begin to fall asleep. You will begin tossing and turning. The mind is whirling in thoughts, both consistent and inconsistent, dreams and fantasies. But you remain at the center, witnessing the entire process. All religions of the world teach doing. You are asked to stop the mind or force the body in a still posture, and then you force the body, and when you force, the body cannot be still. All prayers, concentrations, singing, etc. belong to the domain of doing. You cannot force the stillness. It will then be false. When stillness comes on its own, silence descends on its own accord. In the moment of witnessing, thoughts disappear and silence dawns. It has its own beauty. You do not consider thoughts as your own. No judgment whether a particular thought is good or bad, should it or should it not be there, need to be entertained. You are a watcher without prejudice or judgment. Your being becomes a mirror. A mirror simply reflects without any judgment. This state of mirroring everything, both within and without, is meditation. This state of mirroring everything, both within and without, without any judgment, is meditation. Once you continue, it will happen to you. I can speak on my own authority. It happened to me. It happened to Buddha. It happened to Jesus, Lao Tse, Zarathustra, and many other masters. Maybe a few days may pass, or a few years as well, but certainly it will happen to you one day. You continue to remain a witness. You may take time, which will depend on each individual. You can be a doer and witness at the same time. You can eat, walk, sleep, talk, etc., and yet be a witness. You can move your hand unconsciously or as a habit, or move it with full awareness. There is a qualitative difference between the two. When you move it unconsciously, it is mechanical, it is habit. And when you move the hand full of awareness, there is a certain grace. Even your hand will feel silence within. What to say of the mind? Constant watching leads to the disappearance of thought process. Ultimately, constant watching leads to disappearance of thought process ultimately. Mind is doing. All religions teach doing. Be a watcher without any judgment. This is meditation. It is easy to teach science. Very easy. Because it consists of something observable. It relates to the objective world. The student can see what is happening with his own eyes. He can see water evaporating at 100 degrees. There is not much of a trouble in teaching science. Just a very average intelligence is needed. To teach art is a little more difficult because tremendous intelligence is needed. If a person wants to be a painter, he will have to learn two things, not one. In science, he has to learn only one thing. He has to become informed. If he wants to be a painter, he has to learn the technique of painting and the art of painting, which are two totally different things. For a technician, painting is only a question of arranging colors in a certain pattern and with a certain geometry, certain proportions. It is absolute silence. But then it cannot be a great piece of art. It may be perfect technically, but something will be missing in it. It will not be original. It will be a repeat. Because for originality, not only technique is needed, for originality, immense intelligence is needed. Zen monks have been painting for thousands of years, and they say, to learn the real painting, one has to learn the technique for 12 years. And then for 12 years one has to stop painting completely and forget all about it. And then after those 24 years, one has to start painting again. So the technique is forgotten. So the technique does not come in between you and the painting. Now you can start painting as if you do not know painting. You do not know the technique of painting, so you can be original. And in that process, the painting, the art grows within you. That gestation period is needed. After the child is conceived, a period of 9 months is needed to go into a different state. This is a state of happening. The second stage of 12 years is far more important than the first. The technique has to be learned, certainly, without knowing about colors and canvases you cannot paint. But that is only a preliminary process. Then you have to forget all about it so that you do not become addicted to the technique. The technique goes deep into your blood and bones, but you are not at all self-conscious about it. It functions, but you are now free from technique. It does not hinder you. Art, music, poetry, painting is far more difficult to teach, a longer process. A knack is the most difficult thing to teach because it needs three things. It needs a certain technique, it needs tremendous intelligence, and also it needs some intuitiveness. Intuitiveness is the highest peak of intelligence. The very word intuition is significant. Education is tuition. Somebody teaches you. Intuition is something that happens to you. It cannot be brought in from outside. The master can teach, can create a certain atmosphere, a certain energy field. It is very indirect process. It is just as a gardener prepares the ground and then sows the seed and then weeds. There is nothing else that he can do about it. Now everything depends on the seed. They will find their way in their own time. It will be something like intuition. You cannot persuade the seed to grow faster. You can tell them this is the time, go ahead. You cannot order them. You can simply wait. Prepare the ground, remove the barriers, rocks, weeds, and all such things. Give them a beautiful bed, watering, sun, and then wait. Then wait for their own intuition to unfold. You cannot do more than that. That is the function of the master. To create an energy field in which your intuition one day suddenly becomes a field. It cannot be caused. It cannot be forced. It can only be held. And that too in a very soft. My work is to help you to find where you have put it and to find how to open it. And then life becomes a splendor and grandeur of dimensions that are inconceivable. Then for the first time you know what depth means, what height means. Then you are no more flat. And any depth or any height you have. The real adventure begins when you start moving deeper into your being. And also higher into your consciousness. And the processes are, the real adventure begins only when you start moving deeper into your being and also higher into your consciousness. And the processes are two sides of the same coin. If you go deeper, you go higher as well and vice versa. It is one dimension, the vertical dimension. People who are living a flat life are living horizontally. Their life is just like a flat tire that is already punctured. This is the way one attains to meditation, and meditation is the only religion. Meditation is the only religion.